Are you a boy or a girl? I feel like every 2 weeks or so I like answering this question for my new followers. Anyway, hi, I'm Desi. Biologically, I am a boy. Socially, I am gender fluid. If you're wondering if I go by Mr. or Mrs., I actually go by Teacher Fambrini or just Desmond.
No, I'm not cis.
Ha! She.
Oh, I use all pronouns.
All of them?
Yeah, all of them.
Well then, how do I hurt your feelings?
You can't.
I just told my Christian grandmother that I am non-binary, pansexual, and that my name is Grayson now. And she gave me this, gave me a hug, told me she loved me, and that I was her grandchild, and I will always be her grandchild. I can't stop crying.
Hey yo, non-binary check.
Shut up, count your calories. I never look good in mom jeans. Wish I was like you, blue-eyed blondie bird.
I'm doing well, how are you? Billy is using they, them pronouns now. We're just doing our best to be supportive, you know, it's a family effort.
Help your sibling bring the groceries into the house, please.
Sam, can you get your sibling in here, please? I need them to come get their laundry.
This kitchen is a disaster. Alex, get your siblings in here. We're on dish duty.
Do not touch your sibling that way.
Billy, please come help Sam with the dishes. They need some help.
What are the pronouns of this household? We need to have a family meeting.
Just like Shakira, no, you're Catherine Zeta, actually.
I'm Ethan, and I'm 14, slaying all these women with my massive peen.
The best part of not having a gender is that every attraction I feel is gay.
You do have a gender, it's whatever's in your pants.
Everyone, I'd like you to know that my gender's 67 cents a pen cap and some lint.
You're just trying to force homosexuality on me with your gay agenda.
Dude, I'm non-binary. I don't have a agenda. This joke is so dumb.
Hey, what are your pronouns?
Bad, baddie, baddie thickums, bad bitch, big booty hoe, and thick coochied beach.
1, 2, 3,
fuck it.
So after coming out as non-binary, some people have asked me like what my biggest struggle has been after coming out. And personally, I think the biggest issue for me is
Today's segment of explaining terms in the LGBTQ plus community, we have non-binary. There's a ton of different descriptions about what non-binary is, but the simplest one I could find is on Wikipedia, where it states that non-binary is a gender spectrum which is not exclusively male or female. Non-binary folks identify out of the typical gender binary. Now you might be asking, the heck is a gender binary? Gender binary is the classification of gender into two distinct forms of masculine and feminine. Most non-binary folks use the pronouns they, them. Always remember that non-binary is a spectrum, and if you have a friend that's non-binary and you're not sure what they're comfortable with, don't be afraid to ask them. Most people aren't offended if you accidentally misgender them. Just correct yourself and respect their pronouns after that. More information will be down in the comments, and I'll probably be doing intersex next.
Wait.
Go. Cash on me, I got hit the lottery.
Ladies are hot. They're so very hot. I don't even care. I'll run my hands through your hair. You wanna run your fingers through mine, but my dread's too thick and that's alright. Hold on, wait a minute. Feel my heart's intention. Hold on, wait a minute. I left my consciousness in the...
Ain't really fuck with me way back then, but how about now? Cause I'm up right now, and you simply suck right now. Hey, you would never give me playback.
Wow! Mm-hmm. Okay. Right, we'll call you back later, okay? Okay, bye. Wow!
I might just go psycho. Too many drunk white hoes.
It do not matter.
If I see one more TikTok of a half-naked boy staring at the camera, doing nothing, with the caption, "This took hours to make," with thousands of likes, I'm going to lose my marbles.
I'm ill, yeah. Bitch, I'm fucking reptilian. Bitch, bitch, all your bitches was wrong. Talking about I felt, you ain't even get on. Bitch, bitch, y'all, all your bitches is pretty.
I wanna be a pretty girl!
Well, you're not a pretty girl! And you know it!
I wanna be!
I hate when guys are like, "Oh, take off your shirt, let me see what you're working with." Okay, one, bold of you to assume I'm comfortable with my naked body. And two, there ain't nothing to see. There literally is nothing to see. What do you wanna see? There's nothing. Hey, babe.
Mm-hmm.
Will you read this word for me?
Mm-hmm. What? Mel off?
It's an English word. Do you know what it is? Mel
off?
I don't know. Why don't you try it?
What do you mean? What should I do?
Turn it on!
Okay, so... On?
Mel it!
Put a finger down if while you were in high school, you went to your sex ed class every single day and they would do an exercise where you would ask a question anonymously. And you were like the only gay kid in the class, I'm pretty sure at least. And so, you know, your question would always have to do with homosexuality, okay? And like things pertaining to that. And he would always skip them. He would always skip them. No one else's but mine, okay? And then after class, you go and confront him about it. And you're like, "Why did you skip mine? Like, it's like, what is the problem?" And he said, "Oh, it's because we're like not in that section yet." And I was like, "What section?" He was like, "Oh, we're just not ready for the conversation yet." And I was like, You talked about chlamydia for 3 weeks. You talked about chlamydia for 3 weeks. Why can't I know what to do and what not to do?
Martin, are you circumcised?
What?
Are you circumcised?
Well, don't ask me, ask my wife.
In
high school, I went to this party and I passed out on a waterbed with this boy that I really liked. And then we woke up in the middle of the night to go hook up on top of a ping pong table. Well, that very same morning, I went to church and I asked God to forgive me for it. And he did. He did.
So the other day, me and the fam were just like hanging out, watching movies, because that's all there is to do during quarantine or whatever. And I wasn't really paying attention. I was just looking at my phone, and my dad pauses it, and he looks up at me and goes, "Parker, you just missed a hilarious gay reference. Do you want me to rewind?" Sir, what?
So you can call a switch a top or a bottom, and they're going to be like, "Yeah, you're right, no matter what you say." You can call a bottom a top, and they'll just like giggle and correct you. But fuck me, call a top a bottom? Yeah, they're going to get I'm a top tattooed across their forehead. They're going to sleep with your mum. They're going to kill everyone you love.
That was a pretty boy.
Yeah, it was a pretty boy.
Oh. I like pretty boys.
Me too.
When I hear straight people complain about the dating life, I honestly can't even help but laugh because they do not realize how easy they have it compared to us gays. So let me just put that into perspective. Approximately only 5-10% of people are actually gay, so that already limits my choices by 90%. Second, you actually have to fucking connect with this person, and I would say that it's pretty rare to come across somebody that you connect with on a real deep emotional level. Third, sex. Some gays are strictly a top or strictly a bottom, although there are some people that are verse. If you are verse, hit me up. But if you're strictly one or the other, you're probably gonna want to date somebody that's the opposite of you. And then fourth, location, situation. I rarely meet gay people in public. I never go out and meet somebody gay and just kind of hit it off. That is such a fairy tale that never fucking happens. So yeah, that makes you resort to dating apps, and those are fucking shitty. Those suck. Like, if you want a part two.
They say that love hurts, but gay love is just a pain in the ass.
Dude, come here.
What?
You're gay?
Yes.
Oh, that's so cute. You got like a boyfriend or what?
Shut the fuck up.
Oh, I fucking know. You know how I know, dude? Because you'll be looking around and shit. A lot of people will be scared here. A lot of people will be scared.
So these are some things that gay people can't always relate to. Right, so if you're straight and you're still watching this, maybe you're not straight because you want to know if these relate to you.
Okay, babe, if I can get you to say no, you have to give me $50.
If you could get me to say no?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so there's a left door, a middle door, and a right door. Which one do you choose?
Do I have to choose?
Yes, choose a door.
What if I don't want to?
Just choose a door.
Okay, the right.
Okay. There's a left door, a middle door, and a right door. Pick a door.
There's another? Yes. What am I, in a freaking maze?
Pick one.
Oh my god. Can I just die?
Just pick a door.
Oh my god, the middle.
Have you heard of this before?
No.
Fucking bitch, I got you.
How?
You said no.
That was a whole...
Yes!
That's so dumb.
Oh my god.
Goodbye.
So my dad asked me to do some farm chores today. So I figured I'd make a look out of it. Color coordinated, found this hoodie, cropped it. Vibe.
Are you talking to a guy that you probably met online and he takes long to reply, but you just don't have the time? He leaves you on red and it messes with your head. Are you talking to a guy?
We could have been a good couple. We could have had something special. But you one crazy ass bitch.
Hear me out.
What?
A bottom who pays for everything?
That's you.
We're doing it all wrong.
So I got my Eagle Scout before they actually let gay people into scouting.
wild, right? That was actually really challenging because I was really bad at being in the closet. If there was a merit badge out there for being a straight person, I would not be able to get that. One day I was on a camping trip that was 9 days long. And on day three, I described something as beautiful. And get this, it's nothing manly like a tree or anything. No, it's a flower. The other scouts crucified me, and they would not let me play any of their reindeer games. They laughed at me, they called me metrosexual, which I didn't even know was a word. I learned it on that camping trip, actually. But now I'm an adult, and I can call anything beautiful that I want to. Beautiful. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. This one's kind of ugly, but...
Attention. Attention, boyfriend. It is now time to give me unlimited attention. You have 5 seconds to report to duty.
So one time I went to a gay bar on an 18 plus night because I was only 19, you know, you gotta be 21. So anyways, I meet this guy there who said he was pretending to be straight so that all the gay guys would be more likely to hit on him. I said, that's kind of pointless. Why don't you just be gay so the gay guys will hit on you? So I straight up asked him, I said, yo, why are you pretending to be straight? He goes, why? Do you want to dance or something? I said, maybe, but also I was just curious. I'm not even kidding. He says, I saw my older brother here and he doesn't know that I'm gay. So I told him that I'm straight. I was like, but you're at a gay bar. And then I saw this guy watching us talk and I said, hey, is that your brother? He looked over at him like this and then nodded at me like, yeah. And then I was like, okay, ready? I straight up leaned in and kissed him on the lips. He wasn't even mad though. And then his brother just came over and was like, I knew it.
Go through this with me one more time.
Okay.
If he does it and I let him,
you're a slut.
Right. And if he wants to, but I stop him,
you're a tease.
God. And if I let him and I like it,
you're a skank.
Wow.
Okay, so yesterday, I was going through TikTok, and I was on my For You page, and my favorite gay TikToker, Alaskan Boy, he showed up, and he was talking about how he can smell people through their videos, like, as a superpower. So I just commented, I was like, what do I smell like? And he responded, which, first of all, like, oh my god, I'm famous. And second of all, he said Axe body spray. Like, do I look like I smell like Axe? Do I look like I use Axe? Because... if I do, you guys need to tell me that kind of stuff before I, like, go out into the world. Because that is so gross.
Shit, sweetie. What? Fucking call the cops.
What?
Turn around.
What?
Someone stole your ass.
Who stole my ass?
So I went to Starbucks today, and I placed my normal order of a venti iced blonde caramel macchiato with almond milk, and the barista on the headset asked me, do you want a free coffee? So, of course, I said, yeah. And I asked him, how do I get the free coffee? And he was like, oh, well, if you give me your phone number, you can have a free coffee. And then maybe, you know, we could see where things go from there. And I was like, no, what? No, I'm not going to give you my number. What are you, nuts? Stranger danger, buddy.
Hey, I like you.
I like you, too.
So I was thinking that maybe we could...
Listen, I don't do relationships, but we can talk every now and then, hang out, we can kiss and stuff like that, but, like, I'm not yours, but you can't talk to anybody else.
Okay.
Who wears the pants? Who made the first move? Who's a better kisser? Who's smarter? Who works harder? Who's always right? Who's gonna make more money? Who wants to get married first? Who's funnier? Who wants more kids? Who wears the pants? Who needs the most attention? Who's more likely to get away with murder? Who's most athletic? Who buys better gifts? Who texts first in the morning? Who's more attractive? Who's the most adventurous? Who's hornier? Who's more outgoing? Who's most likely to become TikTok famous?